Hello everyone, I welcome you all for this VTU e-Sikshana program on the course Kinematics of Machines. In this module 3, we were discussing on velocity and acceleration analysis of mechanisms. So far, in our previous lectures, we have discussed complex algebra method for determining the velocity and acceleration of 4 bar mechanism and slider crank mechanism, and also we have worked out 2 numerical problems on each of these 2 cases, that is one problem on 4 bar mechanism and another problem on slider crank mechanism. From today's lecture, that is from lecture 5 of this module 3, I will be beginning Fredrstein's method for conducting velocity and acceleration analysis of 4 bar mechanism as well as for slider crank mechanism. So, in today's lecture, let us discuss angular displacement analysis for 4 bar mechanism using Fredrstein's method. Come, let us discuss Fredrstein's approach. So, in today's lecture, we are discussing on Fredrstein's method. So, under Fredrstein's method, we will be discussing on angular displacement angular velocity and angular acceleration. Analysis of 4 bar mechanism first, and later I will take up slider crank mechanism. So, it is Fredrstein's method. So, in today's lecture, let me discuss angular displacement analysis for 4 bar mechanism. You know, to discuss angular displacement analysis for 4 bar mechanism, let us take a 4 bar mechanism like this. Let me consider a 4 bar mechanism in a Cartesian coordinate system like this. Let us have the fixed link. Let call fixed link as AD, which is fixed. Let us call this input link, which is nothing but crank. This you people already know, crank is nothing but input link for us. Let the input link will be at an angle of theta measured in counterclockwise direction from positive x axis, all or with reference to fixed link. Next, let us call this link BC. As this you people already know, this is called as coupler or transmission link. Let us mark the coupler angle as beta, which is measured in counterclockwise direction from positive x axis or with reference to fixed link. And for simplicity, let us measure the angle of output link, which is nothing but rocker, which is nothing but output link. Let the angle made by output link be called as phi. Now, in Fredrstein's method, we will replace the link lengths by vectors. Let the link length of link AB can be called as small a, BC can be called as small b, and CD can be called as small c, and link AD, fixed link, can be called as small d. So, let us replace these link lengths A, B, C, D by vectors. So, if I represent the vector directions, so this is the direction and the link length is A. For B, C, let us take this as the direction. For C, D, let us take this as the direction, and for fixed link, let us take this as the direction. So, hence the angle made by fixed link will be how much? So this angle is known for us, this will be 180 degrees. 180 degrees is the angle made by fixed link, that is what we will get. Now, in order to analyze the displacements, that is angular displacement of coupler, that is beta, and angular displacement of output link, that is rocker, is phi. In order to analyze this, we are assuming that we know the values of all the link lengths and also what is the input crank angle, theta is known for us. That is, I know A, B, C, D, and also I know what is the value of theta. Apart from that, I know what is the angular velocity of crank, that is omega 1. Let us call this as link 1. Let link AB can be turned as link 1. Similarly, link BC can be considered as link 2. Link CD can be taken as link 3, and link AD, which is nothing but here, if I read, it is coming to be DA for us. In a cyclic manner, if I read, DA is a fixed link, let us take the fixed link as link 4 for simplicity. And the angles made by these links are also known. The angle made by link 1, that is crank angle, is theta. Angle made by coupler is beta. Angle made by rocker is phi. Angle made by fixed link is 180 degrees. Now, if I conduct vector analysis, I can determine what is the angular displacement beta and phi. Let us do that in today's lecture. So, first let us discuss displacement analysis. So, if I come for displacement analysis, we all know that the vector resolution that we have made horizontally and vertically should be equal to 0. For equilibrium, the summation of vectors resolved horizontal and vertical should be equal to 0. So, use that concept. For equilibrium, summation of vector resolved horizontally, vectors which are resolved horizontally should be equal to 0, and also vectors resolved vertically should be equal to 0. So, we have replaced the link lengths by vectors. So, first let us take up the first condition, that is, if I resolve the vectors horizontally. So, if I resolve the vectors horizontally, we have vector A, the horizontal component is A cos theta. We have vector B, the horizontal component is B cos beta. We have vector C, if you observe, vector C is acting vertically downwards, whereas vector A is acting vertically upwards. So, therefore, we should take negative sign. We should follow the sign convention. So, for sign convention, let us use acting along positive x-axis taken as positive, acting along negative x-axis is taken as negative, acting along positive y-axis can be taken as positive, acting along negative y-axis can be taken as negative for the vectors. So, let us adopt this sign convention. So, if I resolve the vectors, I am going to get A cos theta. So, resolving horizontally, I will get A cos theta plus B cos beta minus C cos phi minus D cos of 180 degrees should be equal to 0. So, this is what we have. So, therefore, if I resolve it, I am going to get A cos theta plus B cos beta minus C cos phi plus D should be equal to 0. should be equal to 0. So let us calculate the value of phi. Hence let me take, let me retain cos beta and send all other terms to RHS. If I send all other terms to RHS, I will end up with B cos beta is equal to minus A cos theta plus C cos phi minus D. Let us call this as equation number 1. Now if I square this equation on both sides, that is horizontal components will become A cos theta plus B cos beta, then we have minus C cos phi minus D must be equal to 0. So this is what we will get if I resolve horizontally. Now let me calculate the value of phi. In order to calculate the value of phi, let us eliminate beta. In order to eliminate beta, find what is B cos beta. So if I do that, I will get B cos beta as, so we are considering horizontal components, B cos beta will become C cos phi plus D minus A cos theta. Now let us square on both sides. Squaring on both sides, if I square on both sides, I am going to get the expression as B square cos square beta will be equal to C cos phi plus D minus A cos theta whole square. This is what I will get. A cos theta whole square. This is what I will get. Now, if I simplify, this is of the form A plus B plus C whole square. A plus B plus C whole square is known for us. It is A square plus B square plus C square plus 2AB. 2 times AB is C into D cos phi. 2AB plus 2BC. So we have minus sign, hence it will become minus 2 minus 2. B value is D and C value is A cos theta. And finally we have 2AC, that is minus 2C times A cos phi cos theta. So this is what we have. A plus B plus C whole square is A square plus B square plus C square plus 2AB plus 2BC plus 2CA. So we have obtained the expression for B square cos square beta. Let us call this as equation number 3. Let us call the horizontal component of vectors as equation number 1. Let us call the expression for B cos beta as equation number 2, and let us call this as equation number 3. So this is what I obtained for B square cos square beta by conducting resolution of vectors along horizontal axis or horizontal components. Moving ahead, for resolving the vectors vertically, if I resolve the vectors vertically, so what I am going to get, if I resolve vertically, I will get A sin theta, B sin beta, and we have minus C sin phi, and we don't have any vertical component, hence it will become 0. for D. So hence, if I go for vertical components, that is summation of vertical components of vector, if I go for summation of vertical components of vector is equal to 0. If I do that, I will get A sine theta plus B sine beta. So I should use small b, right? So let me use small b, minus C sine phi is equal to 0. Because fixed link is completely horizontal, we don't have any direction or we don't have any vertical component for fixed link. Now let me calculate what is the value of B sine theta. Let us take this as equation number 4. So hence I will get B sine beta as B sine beta will be equal to C sine phi minus A sine theta. So now squaring and adding both sides, that is squaring on both sides, if I square on both sides, I will get B square sine square beta will be equal to C sine phi minus A sine theta the whole square. This is of the form A minus B whole square. So now substitute for A minus B whole square, I will get B square sine square beta A square, that is C square sine square phi, C square sine square phi A square plus B square, that is A sin theta plus A square sin square theta, A square plus B square minus 2AB, that is minus 2 times AB, that is CA sin theta sin phi. So this is what we are going to get. Now squaring and adding these two equations, that is let us call this as equation number 5. So we have equation number 3 for B square cos square beta and we have equation number 5 for B square sin square beta. So if I add equation 3 and 5, adding equation 3 and equation 5. If I add equation 3 and equation 5, we have B square cos square beta and equation 5 has B square sin square beta. So it will become B square, if I take common, I will get cos square beta plus sin square beta. This is equal to, take the right hand side of equation 3. So right hand side of equation 3 is C square cos square phi plus D square plus A square cos square beta. That is, we have C square cos square phi plus D square plus, we have from equation 3, A square cos square theta, that is A square cos square theta plus 2c d cos phi minus 2ca cos theta cos phi minus 2cd will get 2ad. 2AD cos theta plus, I should add this term. So if I add that term, I will get plus 2C square sin square phi
plus a square sin square theta plus minus 2ca sin theta sin phi. So this is what I will get if I add equation number 3 and 5. So you can see here we have equation number 3, left hand side is b square cos square beta. For equation 5 we have b square sin square beta. I will take b square common, I will put with cos square beta plus sin square beta. Coming for RHS of equation 3, so we have equation 3 RHS, it is c square cos square phi plus d square plus a square cos square theta. I applied a plus b plus c whole square, that is a square plus b square plus c square plus 2ab plus 2bc plus 2ca. So I have recalled equation number 3 and wrote it, and then I have added the RHS of equation 5. So this is what we have. Now if I simplify, cos square beta plus sin square beta is unity. So let me resolve for each term separately. If I do that, I will end up with b square will be equal to, for c square we have one term here, c square cos square phi, and also we have c square sin square phi. So if I simplify, I end up with c square of cos square phi plus sin square phi. Next we have d square, let me retain d square as it is, plus d square. Next, coming for a square term, we have a square cos square theta, a square sin square theta. So if I simplify, I will get plus a square cos square theta plus sin square theta. Next, coming for the next terms, we have plus 2cd cos phi plus 2cd cos phi, and we have minus 2ad cos theta minus 2ad cos theta, and we have minus 2cd cos theta cos phi, and the last term is 2ca sin theta sin phi. That is minus 2ca sin theta sin phi. So if I check out, we have 2ca cos theta cos phi. So this is 2ca cos theta cos phi. So this is what I am going to get. So further simplification will yield us cos square theta plus sin square, cos square phi plus sin square phi is unity, cos square theta plus sin square theta is also unity. So further simplification will give us the value of b square, as b square will be equal to c square plus d square plus a square, c square plus d square plus a square plus 2cd cos phi plus 2cd cos phi minus 2ad cos theta minus 2ad cos theta, and we have, I can take minus 2ca common. If I take minus 2ca common, I will end up with minus 2ca of cos phi cos theta plus sin phi sin theta. So I have taken minus 2ca common, and I wrote cos theta cos phi plus sin theta sin phi. So this is of the form cos of a minus b. Cos a minus b is cos a cos b plus sin a sin b. So hence further simplification will be b square is equal to c square plus d square plus a square plus 2cd cos phi minus 2ad cos theta minus 2ca cos of phi minus theta, cos of phi minus theta.
So you can write it as cos of phi minus theta or cos of theta minus phi. So if you get negative sign also in fourth quadrant, cos theta is always positive. According to ASTC rule, if I get cos of minus theta is cos theta itself. So therefore, whether you can write it as cos of phi minus theta or cos of theta minus phi, it doesn't make any difference. Now with this, I can simplify further and get the value of phi, that is the equation will boil down to be 2ca times cos theta cos of theta minus phi cos of theta minus phi cos of theta minus phi will be equal to, we have c square plus d square plus a square minus b square, that is a square minus b square plus c square plus d square is what I have, plus 2cd cos phi plus 2cd cos phi minus 2 times ad cos theta. AD cos theta. This is what I got. So therefore, I can write cos of theta minus phi or phi minus theta, whichever is convenient you can write it. Let me use common notation, that is always I will take phi minus theta, you know, to avoid confusion. Let me take maintain a common convention so that you people won't get any doubts. Phi minus theta will be equal to, so send 2ca to RHS. If I send 2ca to RHS, I will get a square minus b square plus c square plus d square divided by 2ca is one term. Coming for second term, I will get 2cd cos phi divided by 2ca. And the third term will be minus 2ad cos theta, 2ad cos theta divided by 2ca. So therefore, I can simplify further as, so this will become, I can cancel off 2c, 2c here. So I will get d by a, I can cancel off 2a, 2a here, I can cancel off 2a. 2a here. So hence the final expression will be cos of phi minus theta will be equal to a square minus b square plus c square plus d square, that is a square minus b square plus c square plus d square divided by 2ca plus d by a cos phi minus d by c cos theta minus d by c cos theta. So now according to Fredenstein's equation, he has termed the first term as, let me call this as k1, that is k1 is equal to d by a, and let us call this as k2, that is k2 is equal to d by c, and let us call the constant term as k3, which is k3, which is nothing but having only the linked lengths a, b, c, d are linked lengths. So hence it is a constant value, that is a square minus b square plus c square plus d square divided by 2ca.
So hence the simplified expression according to Feuerstein's equation will become cos of phi cos theta plus sin phi sin theta will be equal to k1 cos phi minus k2 cos theta plus k3. So this is what is termed as Feuerstein's equation to calculate the angular displacement of coupler. That is, we have determined the expression to determine the value of phi. So we have obtained the expression to determine the value of phi, which is given by Feuerstein's equation, which just now we have derived, which is the equation for cos phi. So if you clearly observe, here we have cos phi and sin phi, so solving this equation is a bit tedious. So hence we can further simplify this expression to determine the value of phi. So now to calculate the value of phi, let us use sin 2 theta and cos 2 theta formula from our trigonometry. So if I recall trigonometry, so now to simplify the value of phi from our trigonometric knowledge, we know that sin 2 theta can be written as 2 tan theta divided by 1 plus tan square theta. Similarly, I can write cos 2 theta as 1 minus tan square theta divided by 1 plus tan square theta. This you people already learnt in your elementary classes itself. So use these two relations. If I use these two relations, I can replace cos phi and sin phi as, so cos phi can be written as what? Cos phi can be written as 1 minus tan square phi by 2, correct? Divided by 1 plus tan square phi by 2. So similarly, what I can write for sin phi? I can write for sin phi as 2 tan phi by 2 divided by 1 plus tan square phi by 2. So if you make these two substitution and simplify, I will get the expression for phi. So that is, the equation will further boils down to be, let me recall the Feuerstein's equation. I will call this Feuerstein's equation as equation number 6. So equation number 6 is called as Feuerstein's equation. So if I recall Feuerstein's equation, that is Feuerstein's equation is nothing but equation number 6. Feuerstein's equation. So if I recall Feuerstein's equation, we have cos phi cos theta plus sin phi sin theta is equal to k1 cos phi minus k2 cos theta plus k3, right? So look at equation number 6, k1 cos phi minus k2 cos theta plus k3, correct? So now replace for cos phi and sin phi from our trigonometric knowledge. So if I replace for cos phi and sin phi, I will end up with cos phi can be written as 1 minus tan square phi by 2 divided by 1 plus tan square phi by 2. So this has to be multiplied by cos theta plus sin phi sin theta can be written as 2 tan phi by 2 divided by 1 plus tan square phi by 2, correct? This has to be multiplied by sin theta. So this must be equal to the RHS. In RHS also we have cos phi, replace for cos phi. For cos phi I can replace as 1 minus tan square phi by 2 divided by 1 plus tan square phi by 2 into cos into k1. Into k1 minus k2 cos theta plus k3. So a careful observation is that in left hand side also we have 1 plus tan square phi by 2 in the denominator. In the right hand side also we have 1 plus tan square phi by 2 in the denominator. So let me take LCM as 1 plus tan square phi by 2 on both sides. If I take LCM as 1 plus tan square phi by 2 on both sides, I will get cos theta minus tan square phi by 2 cos theta. Tan square phi by 2 cos theta. Here we will get 2 tan phi by 2 sin theta plus 2 tan phi by 2 sin theta. So this must be equal to, we have k1 minus k1 tan square phi by 2 is one term, and coming for the second term, k2 cos theta should be get multiplied with this denominator, that is k2 plus k2 plus k2 tan square phi by 2 is the second term what I will get. So whole multiplied by cos theta. So this has to be multiplied by cos theta plus we have k3. K3 should be multiplied by this LCM. So I will get k3 plus k3 tan square phi by 2. So this is what I will get by taking 1 plus tan square phi by 2 as LCM and cancelling on both LHS as well as in RHS. So hence if I simplify this expression for tan square phi by 2 and also for, now let us simplify it to the form A tan square phi by 2 plus B tan phi by 2 plus C is equal to 0. So if I simplify this equation to this form, I can find what is the value of phi. So simplify this equation to this form. If I want to simplify this equation to this form, so we have tan square phi by 2 one term here, and then we have tan square phi by 2 here, and also we have tan square phi by 2 here, and also we have here. So totally if you evaluate, totally we have minus cos theta, so we will get minus cos theta is present here. So let me take this to left hand side, I will get plus k1 plus k1. If I take this term, so I have done with this, so then if I take this one, I will get minus k2 cos theta minus k2 cos theta and minus k3 minus k3. Whole this should be multiplied by tan square phi by 2, correct? So plus, coming for tan phi by 2, we have only one term, that is 2 sin theta, 2 sin theta tan phi by 2 plus constant. So plus constant term will be cos theta minus k1 cos theta minus k1, and later we have k2 cos theta minus k2 cos theta minus k3. So this is what we will get, and this must be equal to 0. So a careful observation is that ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0. So hence the value of a will be, let me take minus sign throughout common, and I can write this equation as minus of 1 plus k2 cos theta is one term, 1 plus k2 cos theta, plus k3 minus k1 times tan square phi by 2. Plus we have 2 sin theta tan phi by 2. Let me take minus sign common here also. If I take minus sign common, so I left out with k1 plus k2 cos theta, k2 of, or I can write this as k1 plus, we have cos theta here, we have k2 cos theta, which can be written as k2 minus 1 cos theta plus k3. This is equal to 0. So this is A, B and C. So if I write it properly, let me throughout multiply by minus, you know, to avoid sign confusions. So it will boil down to be 1 plus k2 of cos theta plus k3 minus k1 plus k3 minus k1 tan square phi by 2 minus 2 sin theta minus 2 theta tan phi by 2 tan phi by 2, and plus we have constant, that is k1 k2 minus 1, that is k2 minus 1 cos theta plus k1 plus k1 plus k3. This is equal to 0. So this is of the form ax square plus bx plus c, where the value of a is this one, that is 1 plus k2 cos theta minus k1 plus k3. The value of b is minus 2 sin theta, and the value of c will be c is equal to k2 minus 1 of cos theta plus k1 plus k3 plus k1 plus k3. So thereby we have reduced the equation to ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0. Hence the roots of this equation are, we have tan of phi by 2 will be equal to minus b plus or minus square root of b square minus 4ac by 2a, where the value of a, b, c are computed here. So hence I can find the value of phi as phi is equal to 2 times tan inverse of minus b plus or minus square root of b square minus 4ac by 2a. So if you carefully observe, we will get two values of phi, that is we will get two angular displacement values for output link, that is for rocker, from this equation. Similarly, I can find the two output positions or two angular displacement positions for coupler also, that is I can find the value of beta. So if you carefully observe, we have obtained the equations for resolving horizontally and vertically, that is for equilibrium we have taken resolving of forces horizontally and I have solved for b cos beta. Similarly, I have resolved for vectors vertically and I have solved for b sin beta, instead of which if you solve for c cos phi and c sin phi, if you solve for c cos phi and c sin phi, square on both sides, eliminate sin phi, and if you follow the same procedure what I have done, you are going to get the expression for tan beta. So thereby you can obtain the values of beta by eliminating phi. Squaring and adding both sides, it will get sin square phi plus cos square phi is unity. So therefore I can eliminate phi and I can find the value of beta. If you follow the same procedure by solving for c sin phi component in the equation number 4 and solving for c cos phi in equation number 1 instead of b cos beta and squaring on both sides and eliminating cos phi completely and follow the same procedure what I have done, you have end up with the equation for tan beta by 2. So if you do that and finally if you observe, you will get the expression for tan beta by 2 as, so you can write the tan beta by 2 as, so similarly, so solving equation 1 and 3 for c cos phi, eliminating cos phi, eliminating cos phi, we get the expression for beta as 2 times tan inverse of d into plus or minus d square, so let me call it as e into plus or minus e square minus 4 df divided by 2d, where the value of d, e and f are given by, you will get the value of d, e and f as, so d is turning out to be 1 plus k 4 times cos theta plus k 5 minus k 1, e value will remain same, that is minus 2 sin theta, and f value will be k 4 minus 1 cos theta plus k 5 plus k 1, where again you should know the value of k 4 and k 5, the value of k 4 will be d by b and the value of k phi will be c square minus a square minus b square minus d square whole divided by 2ac. So if you know values of all the link lengths and if you know the value of input angle, that is crank angle theta, I can find the value of beta, and also I can find the value of phi. That is, I can find the angular displacement of rocker and also angular displacement of coupler. So thereby we can calculate the angular displacements of all the links if I know all the link dimensions as well as the input crank angle, that is theta. So I will stop at this moment for today's lecture. In our next lecture, I will take up velocity and acceleration analysis of 4-bar mechanism. In today's lecture, if I quickly recapitulate what we have done, we have derived an expression for Fredenstein's equation. So if it is asked in the examination to derive Fredenstein's equation, we should derive till equation number 6. Equation number 6 is termed as Fredenstein's equation for 4-bar mechanism. The difficulty in this equation is that to solve for phi. So if you remember this equation itself, it is well and good, you can determine the value of phi directly from this equation also. You know, to simplify further, I have used cos 2 theta and sin 2 theta formula, and I have reduced the equation to the form tan phi, and I have calculated the value of phi directly. So either you can remember this equation or you can remember Fredenstein's equation and calculate the value of phi. So similarly, following the same step, you can determine the value of beta also. So this completes the angular displacement analysis for 4-bar mechanism using Fredenstein's method. That's all from this lecture. Thank you all.